Hello students, welcome to Plus One Political Science class. Today I will continue with lesson 2 fundamental concepts. The objectives of today's class are nation and state, its meaning, difference between nation and state. Before the discussion of today's topic, I will discuss the key terms with you. The first term is multinational state, means sovereign state that comprises two or more nations. Narrow nationalism, the doctrine that your national culture and interests are superior to others. Imperialism, a policy of extending country's economic power by use of military force. Psychological, related to mental and emotional state of a person. Now, I will like to discuss today's topic, that is the meaning of nation and state. In political science, the nation refers to a group of people who feel bound into a single body by a shared culture, values, religion and language. Students, yesterday when I talked about the topic nation and nationality, I told nation means a group of people who feel bound by several ties like common history, culture, language and origin, etc. The term state has also already been discussed with you in detail, that state has four elements, that is population, territory, government and sovereignty. I have already discussed both the terms with you, but today I will talk about the difference between state and nation. The first difference regarding their element is that the state has four elements, and I have already discussed with you. On the contrary, nation has common history, language, culture and origin. In case of nation, these elements are not final. It keeps on changing. These do not remain the same forever. And the second difference is about their political organization and works for the security and welfare needs of the people. Here, I tell you that India is a state and we all are its citizens. Being its citizens, we are provided all the government and political security. On the other hand, nation is united large unit of population, which is full of emotional and psychological bonds. Like it's our motherland India, whom we love as our nation. It's our emotion towards our nation. Nation provides us emotional unity. Now, my next point is
state is a territorial entity. It is essential for state to possess a fixed territory. Students, as in different classes up to class 10th in geography, you have done many countries and continent, and you have done their areas also. So, here I mean to say, state has fixed territories and that is essential element. But in case of nation, it is not essential requirement. A nation can survive even without a territory also. So it is not required, a nation must have a territory. Here I would like to talk about the Jews. Students, do you remember the Jews and Hitler? How did the Hitler treated the Jews? How did he treated them in the concentration camps? That time they had name, they had identity, means they had their nation, but they did not have the territory. So they didn't have the state. In 1948, they got the definite territory of Israel. Now, we can say that the Jews have both the nation and state. At present, they have both nation and state. Before 1948, Jews had only nation and not the state. In common usage, the terms state and nation both are often used as synonyms of each other. But in subject political science, they both are used as different. I hope you are clear about it with an example of Jews. If clear, you must keep in mind for the understanding of the difference between nation and state. Now, I will talk about next difference between nation and state, and the next difference is of sovereignty. Do you remember while talking about the elements of state, it was discussed that sovereignty is one of the four elements of state, but in case of nation, it is not essential for nation to possess sovereignty. The basic requirement of nation is strong bond of emotional unity.
You remember before 1947, India was just a nation, it was not a state. Mahatma Gandhi launched many national level movements due to people's love for nation. They had a bond for the nation. The government was British. They were working for their nation. India was not a sovereign nation. India was not a state, but it was just a nation. So the state is equal to nation plus sovereignty. But after 1947, India became state because it got sovereignty after the end of British imperial rule. I hope you are clear about this point of sovereignty. The next difference between the nation and state is that nation can be wider than the state. As already discussed, state has territory and it's a fixed territory, but nation is a community based on common culture or race. So its boundaries can easily extend beyond the boundaries of the state. Like before Second World War, Austria and Hungary was one state with two nations, that is Austria and Hungary. Difference is nation is more stable than the state, means when the sovereignty ends, the nation remains there and the state dies. So when the Second World War was going on, that time when the Hitler died, after that the Germany was divided into West Germany and East Germany because the sovereignty of the Germany ended. But Germans were there, the nation was there. That's why later Germany was divided into two parts. So sovereignty ended, but nation was there. On the same basis, I will continue my point that state can be created on the basis of nation. You remember in class 10th, you have done Jinnah's two nation theory. You remember it? Jinnah demanded the separate state on this basis. He said, there is nothing in common between Hindus and Muslims. He asked from the British Viceroy for the separate state, that is Pakistan. And his demand was, it's a separate nation. Muslims belong to separate nation. And his demand was fulfilled also. So I made you clear that state can be created on the basis of nation. Finally, I tell you that state is a political organization while nation is a spiritual emotional union. Each nation now tries to be a state. As I discussed you the topic of the Jews Israel formation with you. Hope you are clear about today's topic, that is nation and state. Now today you will revise the topic again at the YouTube and you will revise the pages 26 till 48 and do the snap homework questions. And this finishes the chapter. Next time I will start the next chapter, that is lesson 3, Origin of the State. Till then, take care. Goodbye. Thank you.